Chick-fil-A chicken nuggets. Start with that chicken thigh, breast, and cut it into inch thick cubes. You know, approximately. It doesn't have to be perfect. Now set it into a bowl and cover it in pickle juice. That's going to be our brine. Now for the dredge, we're going to use flour, cornstarch, panko breadcrumbs, a tablespoon of powdered sugar, and a pinch of salt and pepper. Egg wash is simple. A single egg, salt and pepper, whisk it. That's your egg wash. Then after at least 20 minutes, take the chicken out of the pickle juice and dry them. And then it goes egg wash, dredge, and repeat. Do that for all the pieces of chicken. Then get our oil ready. Fill it up about under halfway for the pan. And bring it up to heat. Check with the chopstick and throw them in. Remember, if the oil gets a little too crazy, you could always turn down the heat to bring it into control. Then get your paper towel lined plate ready. After 2 or 3 minutes each side, the chicken's good. Plate it up. Serve it with some fries and you got Chick-fil-A chicken nuggets. Yes, It's a black tumbler, but I'm pretty
sure it rules. Damn. Look at that marbling.
Oh yeah.
Slice.
I wanna show you a really cool marinade that I use for beef. It's unique.
Let's go.
Mortar and pestle.
3 cloves smashed garlic. 2 tablespoons chipotle. Oops. Some fresh ground black pepper. 2 tablespoons cilantro stalk. 2 tablespoons shallot. Start working it until it's a nice little paste. 1 tablespoon soy sauce. 1/4 cup avocado oil. Marinade on. Get in there and work it. Now cover and marinate for as long as you can handle it. That's the truth about marinades, isn't it?
So now I pull this meat out.
Tempered it for half hour, let's cook.
Super hot grill pan. Get meat in. So after 2 minutes, I get a 1/4 turn. So 2 minutes and flip. Rest. Pull right around 130 degrees. Rest for about 6 minutes. Now slice against the grain. My friends, what do you want from me?
Now a little squeeze of lime.
Oh, what?
Malt and salt. That's where most of our seasoning is coming from. A little more pepper. Forget it. No joke, one of the best pieces of meat I've had in a long time. I love you, and I'm out.
I am begging you to change your life and make these mashed potatoes. They're so good, you'll cry. Here's the lineup of ingredients. Go ahead, take a screenshot. It starts with the potatoes, 4 pounds Yukon Gold potatoes. You have to use Yukon Gold. Peel and cut each one into 1/4, 1/8, or 1/16 based on size. Next, finely dice 1 yellow onion. Add potatoes to boiling salted water and cook for 20 minutes. Cook onions in 3 tablespoons melted butter over low medium heat, also for 20 minutes. After 5 minutes, add 1/4 cup of water to the onions. They'll look like this when they're done. Strain the potatoes and add them to a stand mixer fitted with a paddle attachment. Add heavy whipping cream, cream cheese, better than bouillon chicken flavor, Parmesan cheese, sour cream, pepper, salt, and cooked onions. Mix on low until everything is combined. Don't overmix. Top with sliced green onions. Now go and make them.
You eat at Olive Garden? You're an imposter! That's impossible! You still don't know how to cook? Why, I oughta fucking... Let's make Shrek's favorite dish! Get the water boiling, put some salt in there!
I made 8 of these videos, how can you not cook by now?
Get your basil! Just like that, oh my god, look at that beautiful...
I wasn't making love with the basil, I swear!
I love you, baby! Wash the basil!
You look so sexy when your...
Water's boiling! Put the penne in!
Why did that make my nipples hot?
That's just Italian shit, you know we do that shit happens. Stir every few minutes until it's al dente, you don't know what that is? Fuck off! Blend the basil with a little bit of oil and a little bit of pine nuts. I'm sorry, baby. At least you get some of my nuts. I miss her so much. Strain the water, fuck the pasta water! Opa! Fuck!
Grab a pan.
Brown some garlic and oil.
Parmesan?
Bon appetit, ho!
Oh, we're making pasta today.
2 cups of flour.
Well, boop, boop, boop. 3 eggs. Whisk. It's gonna start to come together. Keep on mixing. Let it rest for an hour. Roll it out super thin.
When it gets towards the end, we are going to connect them back and we are going to make one continual loop of pasta.
On, rolling. And now we cut them into 12-inch pieces.
Cut into noodles.
Pasta into salted water. Fresh noodles into the sauce. Boom.
Twirl the bowl.
So good. Hit the plus button for more recipes.
Let me show you how to make some fettuccine Alfredo. It's so easy and so delicious. Into a pot of boiling salted water, add in some fettuccine sauce.
Cook for the amount of time it says on the box.
Into another pot, add in 1.5 cups of heavy cream. And 1 whole stick of butter, which is a lot of butter, but I love butter. Meanwhile, take a big chunk of Parmesan cheese and grate it up. We need about 2 cups.
Once this has been cooking for about 5 to 10 minutes, add in your cheese, mix it until it is fully melted.
Season with salt and freshly cracked pepper.
Take the cooked pasta and add it straight into here. Look at how insanely delicious that looks.
All right, let's give it a try. And there you go, that is how to make your own homemade fettuccine Alfredo. It is so delicious, so easy. For more recipes, click the plus button.
Oh my God. Jesus. Do you like it?
Sometimes you can choose to not be a dick. Yes. Thank you.
Hi everyone, and welcome to another episode of Cooking with Ellie.
Doop doop da doo.
Today we are going to be making a strawberry banana smoothie. So let's get started.
The ingredients that you're gonna need are frozen strawberries, an apple, yogurt, a banana, a blender, honey, and milk.
Okay, so when putting in all of the ingredients, we're gonna put in 1 banana, 1 cup of frozen strawberries, 1/2 of an apple, 1/2 cup of the yogurt. Sorry, that was a little loud.
And for our liquid, we're going to be putting in 1/2 cup of milk and 1 drizzle of honey.
Cheers.
So we're gonna try to make this crazy breakfast sandwich we saw on TikTok the other day. Scramble 3 eggs, dump the eggs into the pan, dip it, and then flip it to the side. Do the same for the second one. Cook it on medium heat until the top hardens up, and then you flip it over. Hey! Then you add cheese, add some bacon on there, load it up. Flip the sides over, just like that. And then make it into a sandwich. Success.
Ta-da.
Spoilé d'un pignon, les vitons jetés, et les jantons, les hoppa, les gisolettes.
Baba, what? Try my cake.
Wow, looks wonderful. I love it.
Ah! Why are you
Can I eat it outside?
Okay.
Let's go. You want me to try it?
Yeah. What are you?
Loser.
It's a strawberry, you
idiot.
It's a straw.
Stupid idiot.
It's
Oh my. Get it!
I made you dessert.
What is it? Get your dad one.
It was good, right, Baba? He tried it.
I had one. It was very good, actually.
Is it cake?
Kimo made it.
You dropped
the egg! You dropped the egg!
Insanely delicious one pot pasta. Start by chopping some onions. I'm gonna go for mushrooms and spinach because that's what I've got in the fridge. Chop up the spinach finely so it's not too stringy. And peel and chop some garlic. Heat up some olive oil, then get the onions into sweat. Then in with the mushrooms and season with salt and pepper. In with the garlic and spinach and cook till it looks like this. A teaspoon of dried basil, 1/2 stock cube, and add some hot water. Add your pasta and try to make it submerged as soon as possible. Add your milk and bring it to the boil. Stir every minute because this will burn.
Add cheddar cheese,
taste for seasoning, and drop a like and a follow.
Today we're making fluffy pancakes. To start, we're gonna need 2 egg yolks. 1 tablespoon sugar, 1/2 teaspoons of baking powder, 1/3 cup flour, 1 teaspoon vanilla extract, 3 tablespoons milk. 1/4 teaspoon of salt, whisk. Beat 4 egg whites. It starts to get foamy, add about 3 tablespoons of sugar. Gradually add your egg whites into the bowl. Add some oil to your pan on low heat. Spoon in your mixture. Cover for 5 minutes. Flip. Cover and cook for another 5 minutes. And that's how you make fluffy pancakes.
All right, guys, so we're gonna make a salt bed right now. All right, guys, so we're gonna lay it on there, just like that. All right, now we're just gonna put salt all over it, all over the. All right, we're gonna let that sit for 10 minutes. And while you wait, you can do things like this. All right, so it's been about 10 minutes now. You're just gonna make sure you wash the salt off. All the way. When you're done with that, make sure you pat it dry. You're just gonna pat it all the way dry. All right, and then after that, you wanna make sure you lube it up with some avocado oil. It doesn't have to be avocado oil, but you wanna make sure you have something that lubes it up. It's not for flavor, it's just because it's at a high smoking point. Next season, the whole thing, the entire thing. When you're done with that, make sure you push it in. Make sure it's hot enough. Boom, done. 2 minutes each side. Butter. Butter, throw it in the oven at 350 for 5 minutes. Ooh, baby. All right, you wanna foil it for 15 minutes.
All right.
Ooh. Oh, wow.
Mantequilla, harina, leche, queso cheddar, tocino. Aguacate, sal y limón. Doritos. Salsa de queso cheddar. Guacamole.
Fettuccine Alfredo.
That sounded kind of good, but bring a pot of water to a rolling boil, and then take 4 cloves of garlic, smash them, peel them, and mince it up. And then get 1/2 stick of butter or 4 tablespoons. And you're going to want to heat up a pan. Make sure you turn on the right stove. And you're going to want that to be on a medium, medium high heat. And let that melt down for a little bit. Then add 2 tablespoons of olive oil, and then add the garlic. Let that all melt together and add 1 cup of heavy cream. Mix that up, and then once the water becomes a rolling boil, salt it, add a large pinch of salt, and then add about 8 to 10 ounces of fettuccine, and then salt the cream with a little bit of salt and pepper. You want to be able to part the Red Sea with it. You want to see the bottom of the pan, and then add 2 cups of grated Parmesan. Mix that in there. It's going to become hella thick with like 4 C's, and then add all the noodles. You want to bring some of that water in because the sauce is hella thick, so then you're going to mix that up, and the water is just going to thin out the sauce, and that's it really. Yes,
दिखने में क्यूट है और खाने में सुपर क्रिस्पी है तो आज मैं आपको पोटैटो नगेट्स बताने वाली हूँ यहाँ पे मैंने उबले हुए आलू लिए हैं फ्लेवर के लिए हम इसमें मक्खन डालेंगे और साथ ही में कुटी हुई काली मिर्च सूखी हुई रेड चिली फ्लेक्स और स्वादानुसार नमक डालकर इसे मिला देंगे बाइंडिंग के लिए हम इसमें कॉर्नफ्लोर मिला देंगे ये देखिए हमें इस तरह का एकदम क्रीमी टेक्सचर चाहिए ये जो सारा मिक्सचर है इसे हम जिपलॉक बैग में भरेंगे और इस तरह से इसके लंबे लंबे स्टिक्स निकालेंगे इन स्टिक को 30 मिनट के लिए हम फ्रिज में रखेंगे यहाँ पे मैंने ब्रेड के स्लाइस लिए और उसके बाद मिक्सी में इस तरह से चूरा बना के लिया है दूसरे बाउल में हम मैदा और साथ ही में थोड़ा सा पानी डालेंगे और इसका एक घोल बना लेंगे अभी अच्छे से सेट हो गए हैं तो इन्हें हम मीडियम शेप में कट कर लेंगे इन्हें हम सबसे पहले मैदे के घोल में अच्छे से डिप करेंगे और उसके बाद हमने जो ब्रेड का चूरा बनाया है उसमें अच्छे से कोट कर लेंगे अब इन सारे नगेट्स को हम 30 मिनट्स के लिए फिर से फ्रिज में रखेंगे आप चाहो तो इसे हफ्ते भर के लिए स्टोर करके रख सकते हैं और जब भी आपको खाने का मन करे मीडियम फ्लेम पे यानी कि मध्यम आंच पे इन्हें गोल्डन ब्राउन होने तक फ्राई